Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss what is fixed point representation and how you can express the numbers using this representation. And we will also see what are the advantages and disadvantages of this representation. So let's start. So let's first discuss why do we need actually fixed point representation. So in the previous videos we have already discussed how we can represent the unsigned integers and the signed integers. So for the signed integers we have talked about the three different representation: sign magnitude, one's complement, and the two's complement. Okay. Now in this figure, you can see that we have the integer numbers also. Okay, and we have some fractional numbers also. Fractional numbers something like 4/3, 3/4, which are the numerator and denominator. And we can also express the numbers in like these form, which have the decimal part also, and the integer and the fractional part, like 4.125, -2.7. Okay, and we have some irrational number also. So all these numbers are actually called as real numbers, as we know by our mass knowledge. Okay, so let's say if you want to express 4.125, which has the integer part also, the 4, and which have the fractional part, that is 0.125, how we will express these type of numbers? Okay, in the similar manner, if you want to express, let's say, 4/3, how we will express these numbers? Okay, and in similar manner, how we will express this irrational number like pi, which has value like 3.14, and it has non-terminating value, right? So the question is, we want to express the other real numbers also. Other real numbers are like these numbers. We already know how we can express this -246, these whole numbers, or simply the integer numbers, whether they are signed or unsigned. But let's see how we can express these other real numbers, which are of type fractions, or these integer and fractional parts numbers. Okay, so what I want to actually say is, in the programming or in the maths, we have the numbers like integers and the floating point. Integers are these numbers. Floating point numbers can consist of these numbers also. And let's say we have the fraction numbers also. Okay. And how we will express these numbers? These are like the scientific notations numbers. Okay. And the integer numbers can be positive or negative. Same way, floating numbers can also be positive and negative. So we have talked about how we can express the negative integer numbers. We have the three different representation, as we see that signed magnitude, one's complement, and two's complement we can use. For the floating point numbers, we can use two different representations. One is the fixed point representation and the other is IEEE 754 representation to represent the floating numbers or the numbers which have actually this decimal point. Okay, so in this video we will understand about the fixed point representation. And in the next video, we will discuss about the IEEE 754 representation. So let's see with the help of example, what is fixed point representation? So fixed point representation is actually a notation or the representation in which we have the fixed number of bits to express the integer part and the fractional part. For example, we have this number 13.625. So this is the integer part. Okay, I am denoting it by IP. And this 0.625, it is the fractional part. Okay, so this point can be called as radix or simple a decimal point. Okay, let's say your computer is having n bits to represent this 13.625 or any real number. Then those n bits will be divided into two parts. One is the integer part, another is the fractional part. Integer part, as in this case, it will be used to represent integer part of this total number, that is 13. And this fractional part will be used to represent the fraction part, that is 625. Okay, and this place, it will be treated as that there is a dot, that there is a decimal point or the radix point. But this decimal will not be explicitly stored in any of these n bits. It will be implied. Okay, so it will not be stored anywhere in this integer part or the fractional part. Okay. So let's say your computer is having total 16 bits reserved to store this 13.625. Then it may happen that your computer or your CPU designer may reserve 7 bits for the representation of integer part and 9 bits to represent or to express fractional part. Okay, so this way the position of the, you can say, dot, it will be like here, and the bits for the integer and fractional part will be fixed. So if your computer is having this notation to represent this numbers, then the other person who will be reading your program, he should know that how many bits you have reserved in your computer to express any real number. Okay, so now let's understand this with the help of example. So here you can see we have a computer in which a number is stored using the fixed point notation, and total bits used to represent any number are 16. So this is n equal to 16 bits. Now 7 bits are reserved for the integer part and 9 bits are reserved for the fractional part for this question. Okay, and we have to represent 43 minus 625 in our fixed point representation. So to solve this question, we can see that we have the integer part of the 7 bit, fractional part of the 9 bit, and total 16 bits for this number. So in this number, we have 43 is the integer part and 625, it is the fractional part. Whenever I will be representing any number, I will be using 2's complement representation to express the integer part. Okay. So for example, if you have a negative integer part, let's say minus 43, then I will be representing that minus 43 using the 2's complement. Okay. Although in fixed point notation, you can use any signed integer representation, whether signed magnitude representation, 1's complement or 2's complement to represent this integer part. But I will be using 2's complement representation to express this integer part. Okay. So this is a 43 and 43 is a positive number. Now, likewise, we have to represent 0.625 also, right? So how you will express this 43? So in 2's complement, 43 will be this one. So this is 43, but I have to add this 0. Now, these are how many bits? These are total 6 bits. But I want the integer part to be expressed in 7 bits. So I will use 10 here also. Okay, now these are total 7 bits, but again, this is 43 only. Now, how I will express this 0.625? So for this, what I will do? I will say 0.625 multiply by 2 because I am expressing the answer in binary. So I multiplied this by 2, I got 1.250. Now, actually for the answer, I will be taking only this part. Okay. Then I will take 0.250 into multiply 2. I got 0.500. Okay. Now I take 0.250 into 2. And then I got 0.500. So this 0 will be for my answer. And I take 0.500 here, multiply by 2, I got 1.00. So this one will be reserved for my answer. Now this 0.00 is taken here, multiply by 2, I got this. Okay. This 0 will be for my answer. Now after this, if I multiply again this 0.000 multiply 2, I will got 0 only, right? So all the things will be 0 only. So there is no need to carry forward this multiplication. Okay. So I can say that this is my integer part. Okay. And this is my fractional part, right? So this integer part will be written here. Okay. This 0011011. And this fractional part bits will be written here. And how I will write this fractional part? So I will be starting from the top to bottom. So I will first writing this one, that is this one, then this zero, then this zero, then this one. So this is the this one, and then all zeros. So I have to express in total 9 bits. So I appended that much of zeros. Okay. So these are the 9 bits. These are the 7 bits. Total 16 bit number. So I can say my 43.625 is this number in total 16 bits. Okay. In fixed point notation. So this you have already seen in the number system video, but the thing was there I was actually not telling that how many bits you have to reserve for the integer part and the fractional part. So when we are fixing that how many bits you need for the integer and the fractional part, then you talk that representation as fixed point representation. Okay. So here we will be treating that we have the dot point or we have the decimal point, but we are not storing that dot anywhere in our computer. Okay, only binary bits will be stored. Now let's take another example. So let's say if we have the same number, but this is a negative number, that is minus 43.625, then how I will represent? So the thing will be similar. I will first represent minus 43 and then I will represent 0.625. So for expressing 0.625, the things will be similar. Okay, but for minus 43, again, I have to represent this in 2's complement. So minus 43 will be this one. Okay, so this answer is actually in 2's complement. That means I have expressed minus 43 in 2's complement. Okay. And 2's complement, you know how you can express. First write the 43 representation and then you just flip and then you add one. Okay, this was the two's complement representation. Now, how you will express 0.625? So the thing will be similar. You just multiply by 2. Okay, so I multiply by 2. Okay, now let's say you are not getting 0 here. Let's say you are getting, let's say, 5 here. Okay, so you can carry forward. Okay, just you have to make sure that you have to fill this fractional part using the 9 bits. Okay, now we can say this is my integer part. Okay, this is minus 43. This is 0.625, or you can say simply 625, and here is my point. Okay, so this 43.625, or sorry, this is minus 43.625, is this one in total how many bit? 16 bits. Okay, so this is the way you can express any number in fixed point representation. Just you have to take care that you are representing this integer part in 2's complement. Okay, if nothing is given, you can use the 2's complement representation for this part. Otherwise, whatever representation 1's or sign magnitude is given, you can use that one. Okay, now let's take the one last example. So here we have the computer which can store the number in 8 bits. So 6 bits are reserved for the integer part and 2 bits for the fractional part. That means we have this type of computer. Now we have to represent minus 30. So here you know that this minus 30 is actually a signed integer number. Okay, so actually this integer number can also be expressed using the 6-point representation. Why? Because this is actually 30.0. The fractional part is actually 0. Okay, so in this computer we have the 6 bits for the integer and 2 bits for the fractional part. Okay, so if I have to represent this minus 30, how I will do? So first I will write the notation of the 30. Okay, this is 30 in total 6 bits. Then minus 30 will be, I have to flip them. Okay, I will get some notation and then I will add 1. Then I got this in 2's complement. Okay, and this 0.0 is actually like 0000 only. Okay, in binary also. So I do not have to express explicitly. So I can say that this will be your minus 30. Okay, in 6 bits, and this is your 0. Okay, and here you will have point. Okay, so we can understand this all discussion in this way. Like we have discussed about the different signed representation, 1's, 2's and signed magnitude representation. So actually all the integer numbers we can represent using the fixed point representation, or all the other 30.0, 30.98, these fractional numbers or the floating point numbers, we can also express using the fixed point representation. We have the fixed number of bits. We know where is the decimal point, how many integer bits are there and how many fractional parts are there. Okay. Now, before going to the advantage and disadvantage of the fixed point representation, let me ask you one last question. So the question is, we have to find the decimal form of given representation. So this is the binary representation, and this representation is given in fixed point notation, and total 16 bits are used. Okay, and 7 bits are used for the integer part. That means this is the integer part in 7 bits, and 9 bits are used for the fractional part. Okay, so we have to find the decimal form of this binary number. So how I will find the decimal form? So I will find the decimal number for this binary number separately, and for this fractional part number separately. Okay, so as this is my integer part, and this integer part is expressed in 2's complement representation, as we are seeing from the last example also, I have to convert this into the decimal form. So I will first flip this representation. That means I flip, and after that I added 1 to find the 2's complement representation. So I got this one. So this will give me the magnitude as 12. So this is like 8 plus 4, 12. And this is a negative number, as this last bit is telling me that this is a negative number, right? So I got minus 12, okay, in decimal. So this part is actually minus 12. Now let's see what is this fractional part, okay? So this is our fractional part. So how I will convert this into the decimal form? So in number system video, we have seen that each of these digits will have some weight. So this will have weight 2 to the power minus 1. This will have weight 2 to the power minus 2. This will have weight 2 to the power minus 3, and so on. So I will multiply each binary digit by their weights. So here you can see I multiplied. So 1 into 2 to the power minus 1, I multiplied this by 2 to the power minus 1. I multiplied then 1 into 2 to the power minus 2. Okay, this one. And after that, 0 multiplied 2 to the power minus 3. This bit multiplied by their weight, and so on. So this last 8 bit is multiplied by 2 to the power minus 8. And 9th bit by 2 to the power minus 9. Okay, so after solving this, I will get this answer. Okay, so this was expressed as 1 upon 2, this was expressed as 1 upon 4, and so on. So these digits, this part will be reduced to like 0. Okay, so I have not written. So this is my fractional part. So I can say my total answer will be minus 12, that is the integer part, 0.75, this one. Okay, so this is my total answer or the decimal form corresponding to this fixed point representation of the 16 bits. Okay, so this is how we can find the decimal form for a given binary fixed point notation. So let's discuss some of the advantages and disadvantages of the fixed point notation. So fixed point representation actually provide the greater performance in comparison to the floating point representation. So in some of the computer, as you know, we have the separate floating point unit which performs the operations on the floating numbers, and we have the integer part or the integer unit inside the CPU which do the arithmetic operations on the integers. So as fixed point numbers are stored in the memory in the same way as we store the integers, so all the optimization that we perform on the integer, they can be used on the fixed point numbers also. So you can say fixed point designs or the fixed point hardware units, they can perform faster and they can consume less number of resources with compared to the floating point designs. Okay, so integer unit actually take the less space also on the your computer motherboard with comparison to the floating point unit also. Okay, so in that comparison, the numbers which are represented using the fixed point notations, they can consume less power or the provide the better performance in comparison to the numbers which are expressed using the floating point representations. So what is the disadvantage of the fixed point notation? So fixed point representation can actually express less number of values in comparison to your floating point representation. So for example, in floating point representation, I have one of the representation, that is IEEE 754. Okay, so for example, IEEE 754 can represent numbers from, let's say, 0 to some x. Okay, and will compare to this fixed point notations or fixed point representation can express numbers from 0 to, let's say, x by 2. Okay, this is just a hypothetical case. Let's say we have, let's say, n bits, okay, to store the fixed point number. In same number of n bits, floating point representation can express large number of values. Okay, so for example, fixed point notation can express 0, 1, 2, and let's say 100, but the floating point representation, it may be able to express, let's say, more number of values, let's say 0, 1, 2, 100.0, then 9999 something, 0.89 also. Okay, so in that way, fixed point notation can express less number of values. So as fixed point representation can express some limited number of values, so due to this, there are some large values which fixed point notation cannot express or cannot represent. So let's understand this with the help of example. So here we have this number which is actually very large, you can see, and this number cannot be expressed in 16 bits fixed point. So here you can see the integer part is very, very large. Okay, so we can find these large numbers in our real life also. For example, this can be the distance between the sun and the earth, or we can find these large numbers in our scientific problems also. So how the computer will then express this number if fixed point notation cannot express them? So actually, if this number is converted to this scientific notation, that means the notation which consists of the power of 10. So here, what I have done, I have moved this decimal here. Okay, and accordingly, I have multiplied it by 10 to the power 8 because I have shifted the decimal to the left side by 8 position. Okay, after this 9, you can put 0 also if you want. Okay, so now this number, which is actually same number, right, it can be expressed. How? So this number can be expressed by the IEEE 754 representation, which is one of the representation to express these floating point numbers. Okay, so we will see in the upcoming video of the IEEE 754 that how it can do this in the same number of 16 bits only. Okay, similarly, fixed point notation cannot express very small numbers also. For example, we have this number, okay, 0 point, and these are so many zeros, then we have 135. So this small number cannot be expressed in 16 bit fixed point representation. So again, we can convert this representation in this scientific notation, that is 1.35 into this 10 to power minus 12. That is, I have shifted this decimal point here, okay, by 12 places to the right side, and I have multiplied with 10 power minus 12. So this is the exponent. Okay, so now again this representation, which is actually the same representation of this number, can be expressed by the IEEE 754 representation. So this exponent is negative. IEEE can support this negative exponent also, which fixed point notation cannot do actually. Okay, so these are some of the limitations of the fixed point representation. So before finishing this video, let me tell you some of the applications of the fixed point representation. So actually this representation is not so much used to represent the fractions or the floating point numbers. Floating point numbers, something like 4.5 into 10 power 9. But then also you can find some of the great applications which use fixed point notations. So for example, we have an application JNU case. This application used the fixed point arithmetics or the fixed point representations. So this application is written in C language. So actually the designer of the JNU case application, they were previously using the floating point representation like the IEEE or the similar floating point representation, but then they moved to the fixed point notation. This is because floating point representation can suffer from the many round of errors. Okay, and the rounding of errors, that is not desirable in case of the money tracking. Okay, so that's why this JNU case used the fixed point representation. And the other application is some of the software libraries like Tremor, MAD, they actually uses the fixed point arithmetics. So these are the software libraries which are used to decode the various audio formats like MP3 and the other formats. So the hardware on which these software libraries are used, they actually use the fixed point representations or the fixed point design. So the reason to use the fixed point notation by the software libraries in general can be like the fixed point notations can use the less power with compared to the floating point representations. So yeah, this was all about the fixed point notation. So there is a question for you that you can solve by yourself. So you have to express this minus 25.13 into the fixed point notation using the 8 bits, 6 for integer part and 2 bits for the fractional part. Okay, so do let me know the answer of this question into the comment box. So if you have any question, queries, suggestion, please write down into the comment box. Do like and share this video among your friends. Please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. So see you in the next video with the IEEE 754 representation. So thank you.